an adventure in every bowl of alphabets.
One gal is eating alphabets.
Yeah?
And a ghost tried to scare me.
What'd you do?
I ate them. Then I had alphabets as part of a balanced breakfast.
A metal license plate.
I got New York.
Montana.
Indiana.
Texas.
You can get any one of 50 states.
One metal license plate in each specially marked box of post-alphabet cereal.
Hey, kid, have a carrot.
A carrot?
Carrot sticks are, yes, indeed. They are delicious. If you must eat in between meals, why not eat nutritious dishes? Like fill a bowl with ice cubes, then add raw cauliflower. Stuff celery with cheese and let it chill for half an hour. Add carrot sticks and olives and any other knickknacks. Then keep this by the TV set for when you want those quick snacks. Well?
Well, but while I'm waiting, could you make me a banana?
Okay, you're a banana.
Who is this superhero? Sarge? No. Rosemary, the telephone operator? No. Henry, the mild-mannered janitor?
Could be. Hong Kong Pooey, number one super guy. Hong Kong Pooey, quicker than the human eye. He's got style, a groovy smile, and a mob that just won't stop. When the going gets rough, he's super tough with a Hong Kong Phooey chop. Yeah! Hong Kong Phooey, number one super guy. Hong Kong Phooey, quicker than the human eye. Chicka-chong, ticka-chong, ticka-chaka, ticka-chong, ticka-bop-chock-chop in the bow-wow-wow. Hong Kong Phooey, fan-rific!
$6 million man, ready to operate and command. Colonel Steve Austin is the $6 million man, complete with the technology to replace his bionic modules. Check him out with the bionic transport and repair station. Control his amazing lifting strength. See through his wide-angle bionic eye. The man, his bionic transport that becomes a repair station and a working backpack radio.
Captain Crunch's new Punch Crunch cereal always makes Harry Hippo dance. Its fruit punch flavor makes a yummy part of any good breakfast.
I got freedom.
And also, two left feet. And now, super soap shapers. You can use them to turn soap into lots of super shapes.
This one grooves.
This one digs.
This one shaves.
This one scoops.
There's one in every specially marked box of Captain Crunch. There's four in all.
Some fruit and cereal lovers think they know how to have fruit with their cereal. Until the fruit's all gone and there's nothing left but cereal. That's why Post puts so many raisins into Post Raisin Bran. Post mixes the whole grain goodness of wheat and bran with so many sweet, chewy raisins, you can get raisins in every spoonful. If you can get every spoonful.
Post Raisin Bran, the fruit and cereal lover cereal.
There's an adventure in every bowl of alphabets.
One gal was eating alphabets.
Yeah?
And a ghost tried to scare me.
What'd you do?
I ate them. Then I had alphabets as part of a balanced breakfast.
A metal license plate.
I got New York.
Montana.
Indiana.
Texas.
You can get any one of 50 states.
One metal license plate in each specially marked box of post-alphabet cereal.
Have a laugh, we're a
smile. Stick with us for a while. It's the Tom and Jerry Great Ape Show.
Go get 'em!
You'll begin with a grin when you first tune us in on the Tom and Jerry Great Ape Show.
We got 'em! Introducing Tom and Jerry and that big, big, big star, the Great Great Ape.
With that movie, Great Ape.
I am Grape Ape.
Mr. Gigantus,
he's the latest.
Love that Tom and Jerry.
Lots of feet, lots to see. Everything's gonna swing, so get ready. Here we go. If you're small, short, or tall, you will all have a ball on the Tom and Jerry Grape Ape Show.
Grape Ape.
Big wheels are a-rollin', listen to them turn. The big wheel sound of power, with speed enough to burn. Winning, spinning, braking. The big wheel by Marks, with adjustable seat, handy saddlebag, and a quick stop racing brake. Braking, winning, spinning. It's the big wheel with saddlebag and racing brake. Big wheel by Marks. If we make it, it can take it.
It's new Knievel Rowling. Bar-row! Wow!
Evel Knievel sold separately or with the Evel Knievel Stunt Cycle from Ideal.
Pretend they just got back from tennis and swimming, and now they're getting ready for a party. You can also buy other Dusty outfits, where you see this display.
Dusty and Sky, you're beautiful.
The Dusty Tennis Sports Set, Sky, and all accessories sold separately from Kenner.
Hello, Keebler.
Why, that's an elf suit.
Right. I always wanted to be an elf, you know, wear the outfit, live in a tree, bake rich and chips cookies. Listen, how do you make rich and chips so doubly delicious?
We use two kinds of chips, chocolate chips and secret second flavor chips. They make Keebler rich and chips doubly delicious.
Two kinds of chips.
And elves. You're too tall to be an elf.
I'll wear low heels. Nobody will know.
Keebler rich and chips. Two kinds of chips.
Doubly delicious.
Sky, out of time, coming to see all that they can't find. Where folk find fun, they go to the moon now, they get to the sun. Please, please take me along. Now listen, from future time.
Hey, kids, what do you get
when you take a bowl and a can of Alfaghetti.
You get 100 trillion words in every can of Alfaghetti.
It's fun to eat.
Here we are at the Putt-Putt Speedway. Big race today at the Putt-Putt Speedway.
They're off in a flash. I mean a crash. The Putt-Putt drivers are going again. One of these guys is going to win.
There are surprises at the Putt-Putt Speedway. Lots of fun and thrills at the Putt-Putt Speedway. It's ripping, roaring, racing fun.
Putt-Putt Speedway comes unassembled with race cars, drivers made to fit them, and everything else here from Mattel.
Vortex's been completed. We've gone through the time warp.
Activate landing beams.
Can I drive now? You said that when we got close to home.
I'm sorry, Jerry, but traffic around Earth can get pretty bad.
Last time we were near the cream by a weather satellite.
Whoosh!
We're coming in for a landing. Activate magnetic field.
What's he saying?
What is it, Thumb? What are you
talking, Marsh?
Play that tape with this stuff.
We're about to crash.
Now he tells us.
I'm sorry, kids. Testing. 1, 2, 4.
You know something, Fung? The ever-computerized you should get out of the Android business.
Hatch open. I'm sorry about the rough landing, kids, but here you are, home sweet home.
This is my old neighborhood. Everybody must be home watching TV.
This certainly isn't downtown Chicago.
Are you sure we've landed in the 1970s?
Oh, no. Look! According to the yearometer, we're in the year 2465.
2465! We missed by almost 500 years. Wow, I sure must have a lot of homework piling up.
I wonder what could have gone wrong this time. Uh-oh.
What's the matter now?
It's the hydrometric moisturizing circuit. We must have damaged it in the crash. We're losing water.
Oh, that means we can't take off until it's repaired. Oh, I'm sorry, kids.
Makes no difference to me. We're 500 years late already.
I just hope your parents aren't waking up.
Activate memory bank.
Come on now, Doris. Can't you see I'm busy? I've got to play back the repair procedure. Doris, what are you doing? Come back here. Doris.
Hey, look out there, you little bug. Watch where you're walking. Red alert. Red alert. Invasion by the biggies.
The biggies? Are you sure?
Sure, I'm sure. They just sent in their cavalry.
Could I have a wrench, please, Bump?
Is there anything we can do to help?
Just keep that Doris out of our way.
Say, where is he anyway? He hasn't come back. Hey, maybe he got himself lost out there. I better go look for him. Yeah, well, don't wander off too far.
Fum, could I have the repair procedure sequence, please?
Roger. Let's see. One contour shirt, 3 pairs of socks, 2 pairs of thermal underwear. That's my laundry list. How in the world did that get in there?
You know something? You must have been put together with an erector set.
Yeah, boy, come on. Doris. Come on, boy, where are you?
Oh, got me, you big goof. It's one of the biggies in person. He just came off the flying saucer, and he's headed towards the Capitol.
Keep him under observation until we send reinforcements.
Small A-OK, Chief. 10-4, under and out.
Come on, Doris. Who are you, old turkey, you? You're playing hide and seek, Dorsey. I give up. He's just not around. Gosh, I'm getting awful tired. No wonder, I'm almost 500 years old. Maybe if I just took a little rest. Does this feel good? Now, this is what you call peaceful.
What'll happen when he wakes up? Maybe he'll try to kill us or something. I don't know what's gonna happen. Oh, gosh.
Well, shh, shh. He's asleep.
Hey, you were right about him, Sergeant. He's one large soul, brother.
God, we can handle him. Are you ready with those stakes to tie him down? Go ahead. You ready with those ropes?
Got it.
All right.
Got it.
Rope number one.
Okay.
That's it. We'll tie him up. Rope number two. All right.
Somebody tied me down. Who's a big kidder?
You finally woke up, hey, Biggie?
What's with this gully routine? Your cats are all so small. What's wrong with you?
It's nothing wrong with us. It's you.
Me, man? What did I do?
Hey, don't man us, you jive-time turkey. You and all the other biggies are using up all the space of the world.
And what about the energy? Waste, waste, waste.
I still don't get it. Who are you?
We are known as Little Nicks.
Little Nicks?
Right on. Heard of compact cars, haven't you?
Yeah.
We're compact people, dig?
Dig, but how did you all become so small and why?
There was no other way. Biggies like yourself, you were using up all the resources of the world.
And that's when our scientists began working on molecular cell reductions.
And here we are. Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta! Little Nicks.
Well, congratulations on all your smallness, everybody. Now, if you'll please untie me.
Not so fast. That'll be up to our mayor.
Your mayor? Where's he at?
Where do you think he's at? In our capital city, Tinyapolis.
Tinyapolis? Is that anywhere near Chicago? Hey, wait a minute. Don't leave me here all alone. Folks, little friends. Hey, help! Oh, the guys on the playground will never be this.
Fun Time Saturday, come fly with me.
Introducing that king of fun. The one who's okay with us kids.
Person?
Yay!
I'm the marvelous, magical Burger King. I can do most anything. Now watch me, kids, when I twist my ring like magic.
We're at Burger King!
It's more magic, Burger King.
I'm the marvelous, magical Burger King. I can do most anything. I love magic and food that's fun. So I'll make a burger disappear, make it come back here. Turn apples into pies right before your eyes. Turn onions into rings.
As we can see.
Put a shiver in the shake. It's easy for me. I'm the marvelous, magical Burger King. I can do most anything. I love magic and food that's fun. So
you
see
your magic Burger King.
Being is being.
Yay!
I'm the marvelous, magical Burger King. I can do most anything. Now watch me hit when I twist my ring like magic.
We're at Burger King. He's the marvelous, magical Burger King. He can do most anything.
I love magic and food that's fun.
He's got fun, fun, fun for everyone. Burger King, yay!
The Widow Day. Her kids and their grandpa. They lived before fast cars and airplanes were invented, when people knew how to make their own fun. Enjoy olden times, golden times, with a fun-loving family named Day. These are the days.
Day on A, B, B.
watch you do it.
All we have to do is check the moisturizing circuit. Oh, five.
Oh, bum. How many times have I told you? You're AC and the system's DC.
I'll deposit that in my memory bank right now. AC. Was it DC or AC? Is it AC/DC?
Oh, bum, will you quit it? You're giving me a pain in my biofeedback. Are we all set yet? I'm afraid not, Alice. We can't start our moisturizing circuit support system without a few gallons of water.
We'll just have to scout around outside for some water.
Well, I'm getting kind of worried. It's over an hour and still no Jerry.
Oh, no problem, Alice. Fum and I can search for water and look for Jerry at the same time.
Well, good. I'll just wait here in case he comes back. I just hope nothing's happened to him.
Oh, don't worry, Alice. As the saying goes, 47 years ago, Jack Sprat could eat no fat.
Oh, Fum, about your memory bank. Have you ever thought of getting a trade in? Let's go.
Don't give up the ship, little Miss Muffet.
Oh, cut that out.
I shall return.
Unfortunately.
And he's all tied up, Your Honor, and he can't budge.
Serves the biggies right. Coming here, breathing up all of our precious oxygen. Who does he think he is?
I think he calls himself Jerry.
I don't want to know his name, dummy. I just want him and his freaky friends out of here before they ruin our land. Hello, the mayor here. What is it? Oh, not him again. We'll do something, anything.
What was that, the Doss?
Right, the Doss. That miserable monster is eating up all of our national forests. Well, don't just stand there. Do something. Call a dog catcher. Or the horse catcher. Anybody. I don't. What in the name of the diddly is that?
It's trash.
I can see it's trash, bird brain, but where did it come from? Wait, don't tell me. Huh? Let me guess.
We found it outside the invading saucer.
Oh, what nerve. First they land here without permission, and now they're littering up all the landscape.
Should I give them a ticket?
Should I give him a ticket? Should I give him a ticket? I'll make the decisions here, dummy. Give him a ticket. Give him a book of tickets. Give him a barrel of tickets. Swamp him with tickets. Come back here, dummy. I don't care if you are my wife, brother. Take this trash with you. It's not easy being in government. Where do I play golf this afternoon?
I'm getting worried. There's absolutely no sign of Jerry.
Yeah, and we haven't found any water. And if we don't... Golly.
Oh, look at that!
It's a little toy city.
Toy city, you big stiff. Heck, watch where you're stepping.
Did you hear something, Fi?
It almost sounded like a human.
What do you mean, almost? I'm the mayor here. I demand a little respect.
Golly. You're really a little fellow, aren't you?
You sure are a little fella, aren't you?
How'd you like a pat lip, Biggie?
That's coming up here.
You know, Fum, I get the feeling we're not wanted here.
You bet you're big, Bippy. Now you got exactly 5 minutes to fly that silly saucer out of here, or you're under arrest.
Right you are.
Right.
But, Your Honor, we can't leave until we find Jerry.
Have you seen him? He's a black youngster, about 10.
Was he wearing brown pants and an orange shirt?
We haven't seen him. Now, you beat it before we blow up your saucer.
Blow up our saucer? But, Mr. Mayor, even if we wanted to, we couldn't leave without some water.
Water? Did you hear that?
Yeah, they want water.
Water? You gotta be kidding. Look, you big spongers, get out of here. Out, out.
Yeah, out.
Oh, shut up. I'll tell them. Out!
Yeah, I guess we better go, Fi.
Yeah, enough of this small talk.
Look out for the park.
Oh.
You squash that school, and you'll hear from the PTA.
Goodbye, Your Honor. Oops.
Anything you break, you pay for.
Yes.
Oh, tippy toes, tippy toes. Something tells me he knows where Jerry is.
You really think so, Fi?
No, this is a recording. I'm on tape. Of course I think so. They've stashed Jerry away, and our only way of finding him is by jet patrol.
Yeah, maybe we can spot him from the air better. Okay, let's go.
Okay. Program for launch.
Well, I'm not hungry now.
I didn't say lunch. I said launch.
Oh, launch. Okay. Which one is launch?
This one, you should remember.
There they go.
Yeah, polluting the air again.
No sign of Jerry so far.
I wonder what those little nicks could have done with him.
Yes. It must be Fawn from out looking for me. Fawn! Fawn! Down here! I'm a prisoner in the forest! Help!
It's no use, Fum. We can't see a thing through all these trees.
I wonder what those little nicks could have done with him. Uh-oh, we're in trouble.
Our energizers are running low. Let's get back, quick.
My power cells have had it. We're programmed for a crash pattern. We made it, Fi.
Oh, yeah. And there's no damage.
Well, I think I got a dent in my relay station.
Oh, I knew it looks good. Oh, we better get a power boost before our whole system conks out.
Yeah, I'm getting weaker all the time myself. Let's go.
What's happened? You both look so weak.
Don't mind us. It's just another energy crisis.
Well, where's Jerry? Couldn't you find him?
Sorry, Alice. We tried our best, but, well, the Little Nicks have him hidden away somewhere.
The Little Nicks? Who the heck are the Little Nicks?
All right, you biggies. You're surrounded. Come on out with your hands up.
It's them.
Recharge complete.
All right, you biggies. Are we busting our way in?
Yeah, come on out, or we're busting our way in.
You're bugging me!
Hey, look, they're coming out. They're giving up without a fight.
I don't believe it. They're all so tiny.
They're all so tiny. Come on, laugh at the little folks.
How do you think we survived the fuel shortage and the big famine?
Be careful what you say. He's real cranky.
We're going to give you exactly 2 minutes to take off.
I'll do the talking. We're giving you exactly 2 minutes to take off.
What I mean?
Well, we can't leave without Jerry.
Besides, we can't go anywhere without water for our moisturizer.
Well, that's your problem. As mayor here, I'm expelling you from our land. Well, out! Out, you big stiffs!
Out! Out, you big stiffs!
Will you stay out of this or I'm going to have your badge?
Please, sir. Small, sir.
Stay where you are, Miss Biggie. That one's...
Yeah, but you don't seem to understand. I am personally responsible for Jerry. Now tell me where he is.
Nag. We're holding him hostage here to warn all of you miserable monsters to stay away.
Yeah, we want all you miserable monsters to stay away.
Oh. I warned you, Big Mouth.
Can't we at least talk?
Oh, yes. Maybe you'd like to come aboard the saucer.
Hey, yeah, maybe we could even fix you a little snack. I mean, a big snack.
We could program you a nice sandwich wafer.
Are you trying to bribe me, the mayor of Tinyapolis?
Could you make it a bacon, lettuce, and tomato?
Could you make mine a tuna on whole wheat and hold the mail?
I'll hold your mail. Now get out of here and give out some tickets, will you? All of you, out of here! Where's that sandwich?
Sunshine Saturday, come fly with me. She's cute as can be, and as you can see, she sneezes.
Bless you, baby tender love.
Loving her is lots of fun when your tender love's the one. Who sneezes.
Bless you, baby tender love.
Bless you, baby tender love. Take care of you.
Bless you, baby tender love. The doll that sneezes. New from Mattel.
Spin Welder puts power in your fist with Mattel's new Spin Welder race car factory and the 6-volt lantern battery you buy separately. You've got the power to weld two sleek racers. Then you can turn your Spin Welder into a riveting gun and rivet the body. Now, rubber up with Spin Welder Power. Let her run. The Spin Welder Race Car Factory comes with parts to weld and rivet two race cars from Mattel.
Sunshine Saturday,
woo! Now you just play it cool, dude. mouse is probably out looking for you right now. Hey, it's the doors. Over here, doors. You're tickling me. No fair. Hey, stop tossing around. The ropes. Chew the ropes. Way to go. Two away.
One bacon and tomato coming up. Let's see now, where's the bacon?
I promise you, Mayor, we won't do any more damage. Won't you just tell us where Jerry is, please?
How many times do I have to repeat myself? The little biggie stays until your big biggies leave for your time period. Keep the bacon crisp, huh?
But then how do you get Jerry back to us?
We'll mail it. Hi!
Jerry, where have you been? And none of your excuses about being tied up somewhere.
How did you get? And Will, you hear about the little folks I met?
Well, haven't we all? Speaking of little folks, where'd the mayor go?
Mayor? Of Tinyapolis. He was here just a minute ago.
Help! Help! Where is he? Mayor?
Where'd he go?
Yoo-hoo, come on, Mayor, come on out. Now, this is no time for games.
I'll give you games. Get me out of here!
Suffering, sensitron, the mayor's falling down the ventilation duct.
I didn't fall, you dummies! Oh, I was pushed by a horsey dog of yours! Oh, help! Get me out of here! Help!
Oh, no, look at him down there.
Oh, we've got to get him out of here in a hurry. He could get sucked into the air purification unit.
Well, how can we rescue him?
Only another tiny person can get down there.
Or a tiny android.
What a great idea, Bum! For a change, we could computerize ourselves down to the mayor's size.
You can?
Right, fine, let's go. Program for miniaturization.
Reduction circuits on. Activate.
Yay. I think it's working now. Weird.
Look at that tree. Talk about losing weight in a hurry.
Golly. Small world, isn't it? Hi, Biggies.
Hi.
We got a problem. How do we get down there without breaking our necks?
I'll break your necks if you don't get me out of here. Hurry. Help.
We need a rope. Do you have a rope?
Oh, now where would I have a rope? Hey, kids, we need a rope and fast.
A rope coming up.
Help! Help! Get me out of here! Help! Help!
Thanks, Jerry. It'll do fine. Now, why you hold this and I'll lower myself down.
Oh, no. I'll go down and you hold the rope.
I'll go. I'm the male.
Oh, male schmale. My aluminum has a stronger stress factor than yours. I'll go.
Let's make up your mind. Help! Help!
Sorry, Your Honor, we're coming. Now, Fi, you hold this. This is male android's work.
Oh. Easy does it. Careful, Fum.
Good afternoon, Your Honor. How's things going?
It's a really fun place.
You've never seen anything different about me? Now, take a close look. Oh.
You shrank. Hooray for you. I liked you better as a biggie.
I thought you probably liked me better when I shrunk down.
Don't you stand there gabbing, dummy. Help save me. Help!
What's that, John?
I said he needs me.
I can't help you if you don't panic. Help. Golly, look down there. Fine. Help. Can you come down here? I think his honor's having himself a fit.
Grab the rope, Jerry.
Easy, my Fi. Easy does it.
Fi, help! Fi, help!
Quiet!
You were right. I'm sure glad to see you. I should have never come down here with my weak aluminum.
Don't just stand there, Gavin.
Hey, now stop.
Save me. No.
Just relax.
But
both
stop.
Of you. Relax, I said.
Relax. Relax. If you relax.
But no, you stop and grab onto this rope and we'll get you out of here.
But I can't if you don't turn me loose.
Thanks for all your help, folks. Well, I guess it's time for spinoff, Your Honor.
And thanks to the water you've given us, our moisturizer circuit's working fine again.
Good. And I'm sorry about our tiny misunderstanding.
Well, you know, you were right about one thing, Mr. Mayor. We Biggies should learn to conserve our natural resources.
We better get going.
Well, we can't leave without the doors.
Oh, is he missing again? Oh, for crying out, laser beams. Doors!
Get off! Doors, get up!
Doors, you know something. You've been nothing but trouble all day today.
Yeah, and you should be ashamed of yourself. Now go to your room.
And there'll be no television tonight.
Where's the mayor?
Help!
Help! Did you hear what I think I heard?
The mayor!
Uh-oh, the Doris has done it to him again.
Oh, jumping Jupiter! Where are you, Your Honor?
Are you gonna get me out of here, or do I take back my
wife? I'm coming, Your Mayor. Just be patient, please.
Oh. Keep talking, Bill.
Now listen. For future time, we came to see how the world used to be. But something went wrong deep inside.
The bank robbers are getting away. Bertie Bird Air Police chopper takes off. Headquarters has them on the screen. They're turning south onto Route 5. And you're after them. You drop the roadblock and go for a hookup. Now you move it forward, steady it, and lower it. You've got them. Now you bring them in. 10-4. The Bertie Bird Air Police comes with everything you see here from Mattel. Batteries not included.
The Sunshine Family Van with its piggyback shack and the Sunshine Family making tracks. Coming to the country fair for crafts and things that you're making there. Make a swing for baby and aren't you glad that you could make a belt for dad. Next weekend there's a different plan for the Sunshine Family Van.
The Sunshine Family with Craft Book is sold separately. The Sunshine Family Van comes with Craft Book and piggyback shack that you put together. New from Mattel.
Listen to the story that we will tell to you.
The story of the minnow, 5 passengers and crew.
With Gilligan aboard the ship, the skipper by his side.
An unexpected storm came up and tossed them with the tide.
They found themselves a shipwrecked clan, lost on Gilligan's Isle.
Gilligan and Skipper. The millionaire, his wife.
The movie star Professor and Marianne began a brand new life.
What creatures they encountered. What riddles did they face.
What mysteries did haunt them in a strange but happy place.
On the new adventures of Gilligan, Gilligan.
All on Gilligan's Island.
Sunshine Saturday, come fly with me.
I can be any kid on the block.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
They're slugging it out. A left to the jaw, and...
Oh, my block is knocked off.
But you can press it right back on. It's Rock'em Sock'em Robots. Press this lever. He throws a right, the other a left. Knock his block off. You're the winner.
Well, next time.
You can rock 'em, sock 'em with the Rock 'em, Sock 'em Robots by Marks.
Let's play fireman with Play-Doh Pumper Number 9.
Put in the Play-Doh, there it goes. Now pump out the Play-Doh hose.
Make the fireman's hats and the fire plug. Now hook up the hose.
Up the ladder, there he goes. Now pump out more Play-Doh hose. Playing fireman's lots of fun. You can make with Play-Doh.
Play-Doh Pumper Number 9, new from Kenner.
Sunshine Saturday, woo!
The British are coming! The British are coming!
Gee, Skipper, there's a string tied to your toe. Did you want to remember something?
Gilligan, that string was meant to catch a thief.
Oh, that's too bad, Skipper. All you caught was your own toe.
Not exactly, Gilligan. You see, I tied the other end of the string to... my wristwatch!
Well, no wonder your trap didn't work, Skipper. You forgot to tie it to your watch.
I did tie it. Gilligan, somebody untied it.
You mean?
I mean somebody on this island is a real pro.
Darling, have you seen my solid gold swagger stick?
No. Was it a good movie? It's a perfectly dreadful title. Besides, who wants to talk about movies when a pair of $5,000 earrings are missing?
$5,000, did you say? Oh, the poor chap who lost them, out all that money. But then, of course, there are more important things than money in life. Although, for the life of me, I can't think what.
They're my earrings that I lost, darling. The ones you gave me.
Oh, that does it. Call out the National Guard. Police! Police! Man the parapets! Button down the hatches! Stop, thief! Stop! Stop! Stop!
Now calm down, Mr. Howell. Rage like that isn't good for you, physiologically or psychologically.
Yeah. Besides, it might make you sick or crazy.
How can you concern yourself with health when my gold swagger stick and Lovey's $5,000 earrings are missing?
Now listen, something funny is going on here. First my wristwatch, then Howell's stuff.
And my class ring.
And my micrometer.
And my embroidered pillowcase from Youngstown, Ohio, from when I won the title of Miss Avocado.
Gilligan, you must be missing something on this island.
Oh, sure, Skipper. Marshmallow pizzas and lots of streetcars.
Gilligan, what the skipper is asking is, has there been anything stolen from you?
No, why?
Think it's been Gilligan who's been stealing all the articles?
I don't like to think it, but my little buddy is the only one who hasn't lost anything valuable. Come on.
Which way did he go?
Maybe to the cave where he hides all his loot.
Cave?
Sure, that cave.
Come on.
Gosh, it's dark in here.
The skipper will protect us, Marianne. So stop holding my hand and trembling.
That's me.
I wonder if this is where Gilligan hides the loot.
I don't know. Feel around and see if you find any of the article. Wait, I've got something.
What is it?
Oh, I'm not sure. It feels like a fur coat.
Gilligan must have stolen one of Mrs. Howell's minks.
Not unless it has eyes.
Yikes!
I was just out gathering some firewood. What are you doing up there, Skipper? Watching a parade?
Gilligan.
What time does the parade start?
Gilligan appeared to be doing some harmless fishing. Maybe Gilligan has submerged the pilfered articles offshore.
We'll find out soon enough, by Jove. To the seamen! To the sea!
First
Gilligan, remember not to get your feet wet.
Quiet, you despicable thief. It's mine. It's mine, you hear? Mine, mine, mine.
Gilligan must have doubled back underwater. Mr. Howell has him. Bring him ashore, Mr. Howell.
I know you have a pearl inside you, blockhead. I declare salvage rights. I'll call my lawyers if you don't let go.
That particular species of clam doesn't have pearls, Mr. Howell.
Egad, I've been hobnobbing with a pauper clam.
Preston, you've got your feet wet.
Gosh, Mr. Howell, you got your feet wet.
Well, we haven't been able to prove that Gilligan's the thief.
Gilligan is the only one of us who hasn't been a victim to the thief.
I'm happy that he hasn't had anything stolen, because if he had, that means that one of us could be the thief.
How dare you?
Why doesn't somebody ask me what's new?
All right. What's new, Gilligan?
Somebody stole my medal I won for coming in 12th in the bottle top tossing contest.
Marianne.
Hi, Marianne. What are you doing?
I'm, going to the stream to wash out some things.
I'll help you.
Thanks, Gilligan, but, I'll do it myself.
Okay.
I'm sure one of them is the thief. Now, to listen to what they said and look for a clue.
Tree that walks. By George, if I saw up the rights of that species, I'll make a fortune.
There's no such thing as a walking tree, dear.
Yes, yes, you're perfectly right, darling. Foolish of me. Walking tree.
Now, let's track Marianne, shall we?
Yes, my dear, yes.
Gosh, I never knew it felt like this.
What, Gilligan?
An earthquake.
An earthquake? Hold on, everybody.
I don't see or feel anything that might indicate an earthquake in progress.
Oh, yeah? Then how come the trees and the rocks are moving?
Obviously, that's Ginger following Marianne, and the Howells following Ginger. The entire island has become a breeding ground for suspicion and distrust since articles started disappearing.
Yeah, everybody thinks everybody else is the thief.
That's right, Gilligan. Proving who the thief is, that's all anyone thinks of now, and it's terrible. Ah, time to check my camera.
Camera, Professor?
Yes, the one I rigged to catch a picture of whichever one of you is the thief.
That professor is too cool about things. The unmistakable mark of a guilty man. I'll get him with this, by Jove. There. Now to bait the trap.
Are you sure it'll work, Thurston?
Of course it'll work, Lovey. Engineering genius flows through the veins of the Howell family. The thief will snatch at the bait on the end of this cord. You see, the cord leads into the bushes, passes around a rock, then winds through a pulley, which I salvaged from the boat, climbs to the top of the tree, where it's secured to a lever, which triggers a hammer, which will dislodge a coconut, which will then fall on the hollow clamshell, sounding an alarm. Now to get the jewelry, which will serve as bait to catch the professor red-handed. I'll borrow the professor's jewelry. Wouldn't want to use any of my own.
This detective work confuses me. First we were sure it was Ginger, then we were sure it was Marianne, and now we're sure it's the professor.
You forgot Gilligan and the skipper, my dear.
Hal's been acting suspiciously. I know he's the thief. When he takes the bait on this boulder, he'll dislodge the rock, which will roll down the flume, starting the wheel spinning, yanking the cord to pull out the support from under the weight, which will pull up the bunch of bananas, making them hit the primer on the flare. That will be the signal. Now to get the bait article.
I just know the skipper is the old thief. He's too anxious to look like he's interested in capturing whoever did it. When he reaches for the valuable object I'll use to bait this trap, he'll step on the scissors handle, cutting the rope that's keeping the string together, shooting this pineapple into the air, which will come down and hit the start lever on the old phonograph, so it will play loud music as a signal. Let's see, what valuable object will I use as bait? I got it! My souvenir salt and pepper shaker from Oxnard, California, from when I was appearing at the Bijou Theater. I always knew that Ginger had her eyes on these sweaters of mine. She won't be able to resist stealing them, seeing that she's the thief. And when she yanks one of the sweaters off the line, she'll pull that lever over there, tripping those cans of paint, so they'll spill paint all over the ground, and we'll be able to track her footprints. Now, to get another sweater.
Gosh, a string. I wouldn't want anybody to trip on that. Gosh, here I was, just picking up an old piece of string, and I missed the whole entire 4th of July.
Fun Time Saturday, come fly with me!
Mego presents the Planet of the Apes action figures. Dr. Zaius, the orangutan scientist. Cornelius, the archaeologist. Zira, the woman scientist. The soldier ape. And the astronaut. All Planet of the Apes action figures sold separately by Mego.
All this beautiful hair belongs to Barbie. New deluxe quick curl Barbie. A lovely long fall, how pretty it swirls. You can give her pigtails and give her curls. And all this beautiful hair belongs to Barbie.
Now when you buy a deluxe quick curl Barbie, you get this Barbie beauty soap and bubble bath free while supplies last. Deluxe quick curl Barbie doll comes with this outfit and a long fall. New from Mattel.
Your bike can have the cycle sound with Raw Power. It fits on most handlebars and makes the sound of Raw Power. Raw Power, the motorcycle sound from Ideal.
Pass the butter, please.
Hey!
Oh! Gilligan, do you have to shout?
I didn't shout, Skipper. That was my normal voice.
Well, it sounded like shouting.
That's because for 3 days now, none of you have spoken to anyone. You forgot what the sound of a human voice is.
Gilligan's right.
Don't speak to me. She spoke to me.
I have nothing to say to you. Isn't that right, dear?
How dare you say something to me? How dare she?
Keep your words to yourself, Howell. That's telling him, huh, Professor?
Don't think at me.
Gilligan. Say something. You're the only one on speaking terms with everybody. I can't stand the silence anymore.
Gosh, Skipper, I can't think of anything to say.
This is ridiculous. Here we are, stuck on this island together, having to make the best of it, and we've let suspicion and distrust drive us apart.
Marianne's right. We're being foolish.
Maybe we should start from the beginning again and assimilate the data non-inferentially. I read that in my detective magazine. I wonder what it means.
Your idea is sound. However, let's start at the beginning. Now, what do we know to be fact rather than suspicion?
One of us is a thief. Did I say something wrong? Gosh, if we don't find out which one of us is the thief, it'll get awfully lonely around here. Hi, Skipper. Oops, I forgot. I'm not supposed to talk to anybody.
Well, I've been sort of thinking about that, little buddy. Yeah, I mean, well, there's no sense you and me walking around not talking and acting like we don't trust each other. You know what I mean. Gosh, what I'm trying to say is, put it there, pal.
Now can I have my bottle top-tossing medal back?
Gilligan, I am not the thief. I didn't steal your medal.
I know, Skipper. I just couldn't be sure we were really friends again until you got mad at me.
For some reason, that makes sense.
This is a good idea, Skipper. Setting a simple trap for the thief. We gotta find out who it is once and for all.
This'll do it. Okay, hoist. The bait, Gilligan.
Gosh, I'd hate to lose this. It cost me a lot of money.
How much?
20 cents. I had to buy 2 boxes of popcorn before I got the one with the ring in it.
Okay, now let's hide.
Boy, that's some disguise a thief is wearing.
Gilligan, that's a bird.
Why would a bird be wearing a bird disguise? You can't fool anybody that way.
Come on, let's let him out.
Oh, Thurston, I'm so happy you and I decided to become friends again. After all, we do have something in common. What was it?
We're married, my dear.
Oh, yes, of course.
Now, this is a way to do it, by George. Find the loot first, then trace it back to the thief. On the other hand, if I find the loot, I could keep it. Oh, no, I wouldn't dare do that, would I? Or would I?
Why, that pesky bird almost seems to be waiting for the metal detector to turn up some valuable object. Shoo, do you hear? Shoo, shoo! I'm not about to become partners with a raven. Although, I've been partners with some cuckoos in my life. Oh, that was a witty one.
Now, Lovey, let's get back to the thief-catching business.
There! All of our valuables are safe from the thief, whoever he is.
It was smart to forget about suspecting each other, Marianne. We girls have to stick together.
To get at our valuables, the thief is going to have to get into the trunks.
Oh, goody. I love men in trunks.
Hey, bird, get out of there! You'd think that bird was trying to open the trunk.
Attention, please. My automatic intruder detector has recorded the presence of an interloper.
Gosh, I was hoping that his camera took a picture of the thief.
I think that's what he means, Gilligan.
The professor's a real linguini.
Linguist, Gilligan. Linguist. That's someone who's handy with language. A linguini is a noodle.
That's what I mean. The professor has a great noodle.
This is like watching a movie before it's shot.
The image is forming.
It's only the raven.
Yeah, he triggered our trap by accident, too.
And interfered with my metal detecting mission.
And tried to chew through the ropes on our trunk.
Our luck. We're trying to catch a thief, and a bird is sabotaging us.
Oh, wait a minute. Could it be that our avian compatriot here is the perpetrator of the malevolence against us?
I don't know about that, but I wonder if the bird could be the thief.
Let's find that bird.
We were right. There's my wristwatch.
And my bottle top tossing medal.
And my swagger stick, and Lovey's earrings, and my gold class ring, and my embroidered pillowcase from Youngstown, Ohio, and my...
But, dear, all of those things aren't yours.
Nothing ventured, nothing gained, you know.
Well, all of the personal belongings have been recovered.
The raven was just being a raven. They like shiny objects for their nests.
It sure is good to know for a fact that none of us was a thief.
No, I knew all along it was that pesky bird. You can't trust a raven. They're worse than... low profits. Call my lawyers! I'll sue! I'll sue in every court of the land!
You know, I sure learned something about suspicion and distrust. Letting suspicion and distrust get out of hand almost wrecked our friendships together.
You're right. I'll never let that happen again.
Well, now that that's over with, how about a friendly beach picnic to celebrate the lesson we all learned?
Sure, Skipper.
We'll have that case of soda pop we've been saving for a special occasion.
We can't do that.
Why not?
Somebody stole the soda pop. Only this time, we don't have to be suspicious about who's the thief.
Yeah, and we'd better not try to catch him, either. Well, little buddy, the end of another day. We certainly learned something about suspicion and distrust today.
Yeah, and about suspecting people of doing bad things, too.
Oh, Gilligan, that's what suspicion and distrust are. Where's your vocabulary?
Gee, I don't know. Do you think somebody stole it?
Look, Gilligan, vocabulary means, well, the words, you know, and how to use them.
Like in school when they give you a vocabulary test.
Right.
Let's try that, Skipper. I'll give you a vocabulary test.
Okay, go ahead.
How much is 6 and 6?
12. But that's not a vocabulary test.
Sure it is. 12 is a word, isn't it?
Gilligan, you... I can't think of the right word to describe you.
Gee, Skipper, do you have a weak vocabulary?
Good night, little buddy.
Good night, Skipper. See ya.
Fun Time Saturday, come fly with me.
It's a beautiful day for this trap tennis match. In the center for 2 points. The object of trap tennis is to hit the ball and try to trap it for either 1 or 2 points. There's a one-pointer. The first player to score 10 points wins. We're at match point. Johnson serving. It's a smash. No, it's a backhand fake. Trap tennis, a smashing game. From Ideal.
It's so easy to love the Huckabees.
I'm Huckabee.
Soft little sweet little
I'm
Huckabees.
I'm Hillary, please to meet
and the
you.
Way that they hug is sure to please.
I'm Huck.
They're the Huckabees.
She's so lovable. I love the way she hugs me.
All the Huckabees' clothes are wonderful old-fashioned clothes.
I also have her wedding
so
ring.
She's green. The Huckabees.
She's getting married.
The Huckabees, each sold separately. Wedding dress sold separately, too. New from Romper Room.
Thank you.
sure gotta climb a lot of steps to get to this Capitol building here in Washington. Well, I wonder who that sad little scrap of paper is.
I'm just a bill. Yes, I'm only a bill. And I'm sitting here on Capitol Hill. Well, it's a long, long journey to the capital city. It's a long, long wait while I'm sitting in committee. But I know I'll be a law someday. At least I hope and pray that I will. But today I am still just a bill.
Gee, Bill, you certainly have a lot of patience and courage.
Well, I got this far. When I started, I wasn't even a bill. I was just an idea. Some folks back home decided they wanted a law passed, so they called their local congressman, and he said, "You're right, there ought to be a law." Then he sat down and wrote me out and introduced me to Congress, and I became a bill. And I'll remain a bill until they decide to make me a law. I'm just a bill. Yes, I'm only a bill. And I got as far as Capitol Hill. Well, now I'm stuck in committee, and I'll sit here and wait while a few key congressmen discuss and debate whether they should let me be a law. I hope and pray that they will, but today I am still just a bill.
Listen to those congressmen arguing. Is all that discussion and debate about you?
Yeah, I'm one of the lucky ones. Most bills never even get this far. I hope they decide to report on me favorably, otherwise I may die.
Die?
Yeah, die in committee. Oh, but it looks like I'm gonna live. Now I go to the House of Representatives and they vote on me.
If they vote yes, what happens?
Then I go to the Senate and the whole thing starts all over again.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. I'm just a bill. Yes, I'm only a bill. And if they vote for me on Capitol Hill, well, then I'm off to the White House where I'll wait in a line with a lot of other bills for the president to sign. And if he signs me, then I'll be a law. I hope and pray that he will. But today I am still just a bill.
You mean even if the whole Congress says you should be a law, the president can still say no?
Yes, that's called a veto. If the president vetoes me, I have to go back to Congress and they vote on me again, and by that time you're so old.
By that time, it's very unlikely that you become a law. It's not easy to become a law, is it?
No, but how I hope and pray that I will. But today, I am still just a bill.
He signed your bill, now you're a law.
Oh, yes!
Welcome to Uncle Croc's Block, the greatest show there is. My name's not Croc. Nutty people, man, we got 'em. Wait till you meet old Bottle Bottom.
Kurt, it's Basil Bitterbottom. You cantankerous crocodile.
I'll croc it to you. I'll baffle your beanie with Captain Marvels and Junie the Genie, the 695 man too, and Bogey Bear, that old crockeroo. When the nuts from Mush drop by, everything's bow-wowie. Miss Invis disappears, and Billy Bratson yells shazowie. Brady Cat is scared to death. He's lived 8 lives and only has 1 left. But Quacky and Packy don't mind. Boop and Evil Gates crazy time. Listen to your Uncle Croc. I'm the only alligator who can talk. So all you crockeroonies, welcome to Uncle Croc's Block.
Lunchtime Saturday, come fly with me.
Sorry.
Ouch!
Gee, getting somebody to have breakfast with is sticky business.
Cheer up, my porcupine pal. A fruitful breakfast will share right now. Follow your nose. It always knows.
Ouch! I smell it. Kellogg's Fruit Loop cereal.
Oranges, lemons, cherries, and other natural flavors. Start with a balanced breakfast, including Kellogg's Fruit Loops. Follow your nose.
Fruit Loops are good. How can I thank you?
By long distance, please.
A jungle explorer.
Coconut treeus. Toucan birdus.
What are you doing?
Naming my discoveries. And I've just discovered I'm hungry.
If it's breakfast you want to find, I'll guide you to a fruitful kind. Follow your nose.
Snootus frutus.
It always knows.
Kellogg's Fruit Loop cereal.
Orange, lemon, cherry, and other natural flavors. Start with a good breakfast, including Kellogg's Fruit Loops. Follow your nose.
Frutus lupus. Glad I discovered them.
Isn't it about time for Star Time, Uncle Croc?
Oh, sure it is, Rabbit Ears. I wonder who it's going to be today, boys and girls. Uh-oh. Mm-mm.
Yo, it's Cuckoo Knievel!
Star time once again, and today's star... Oh, I thought so, it's him again. Everybody's example of physical health, the perfect specimen since the Grand Canyon. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Steve Exhaustion. Oh, better known as the $6.95 man. Steve!
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Steve, what on earth happened? Did your warranty run out?
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Why don't you sit down and tell us what happened?
Oh. Well, I'll tell you two what happened if you promise not to scoff or laugh or make derisive sounds, huh?
Oh, we promise.
Okay. Well, I broke my ankle while I was shaving.
Oh. What? While you were shaving?
You two promised you wouldn't laugh, scoff, or make derisive sounds.
Now, how can a grown mechanical man break his leg while shaving?
I'll demonstrate to you how I broke my ankle while shaving. If I have a piece of equipment.
Which is?
A four-legged table.
Oh. How's that, Steve Exhaustion?
That's a table. Here, I'll show you what I mean. First, I lather up my entire dramatic face the quickest and most thorough way I know how. Now comes the tricky and most dangerous part of my exciting demonstration, and that is using my personalized electric shaver without dropping the shaver on my... I think I broke my other ankle.
Don't worry, Steve. We'll get you to the nearest hospital. Forget the hospital, Rabbit Ears. Take him to a garage.
What have I ever done to deserve this?
Oh, Croc.
What?
Maybe we can revive him during the Superfiend song.
What a good idea. Sing on, Superfiends.
Our story begins back in dinosaur days, when an earthquake churns rivers to foam. And a caveman named Wacky and his woolly mammoth Packy end up 2 million years from home.
Tons of fat. That's where I am. Now get off of me.
Wacky!
One of these days, Packy. Pow! Right in the kisser.
What'd I do?
Never mind. Let's find some meat. I'm starving.
I smell food.
And it smells like a brontosaurus steak.
Come and get it, you mangy bunch of flea bags.
Steak again? Yuck.
Yes, it is getting rather boring, don't you think, Polar Bear?
Come on, Carlton. You know polar bears can't talk.
Hey, pal, could you spare a steak?
But of course, dear chap, we never touch the stuff.
You hear that, Pack? We eat at last.
Hey, what kind of place is this, Wacky?
This place? It's some kind of water hole.
But how are we gonna get in that water hole?
Leave it to me, Packy old boy. I'm not the brains of this outfit for nothing. Contact!
Yeah, well, here we are, Wacky. Wacky?
Will you get off of me?
What'd I do?
Well, it's nice to have you chaps as part of our family.
We won't be staying, pal. We're on our way home.
Home, please!
Once you're in the zoo, you can never get out. Oh, yeah? Who's gonna stop us?
Him. That's Clunker, the zoo guard.
What's a zoo guard?
Hey, you two, come here. Now, I'm warning you, nobody escapes while I'm around. You got that? Remember, flea bags, I'll be watching.
See? Clunker is a big meanie. He doesn't scare us. Right, Packy? Contact!
We did it, Wacky! Wacky? Where are you?
Where do you think I am? Packy, one of these days...
I know. How? Right in the kitchen.
Well, at least we're free.
That's what you think.
Now we'll never get home.
Take it easy, Packy. I'll think of something. The only way to escape is to get Clunker's keys.
What are keys?
Keys unlock this cage and the compound gate. Thanks, pal. See? Told you I'd think of something. Okay, Packy. Inhale. We're almost there, Pack old pal. Give it more gas.
Get me out of here!
You heard the man, Packy. He wants out. Contact.
This ought to hold you, flea bags.
Well, here's another mess you've gotten us into, Pack.
What'd I do?
Never mind. We gotta figure a way out of here.
How about the old sneeze trick?
I can't take any more of your sneezes. We gotta think of something else. Hey, how about the old sneeze trick? Hey, Peggy, we're free!
Yahoo! Hey, watch this place. place, Wacky.
That must be some kind of feeding grounds for zebras.
Lunch on Saturday, come fly with me.
Red light, yellow, ready for SSP action. Green, go! It's the Golden Railbird against the clock. Kenner's exciting SSP time trial set gives the green light to big drag strip action. Challenge the other guy's SSPs.
Go! Here it comes!
Race against time and take the checkered flag. It stopped the clock.
Kenner's SSP time trial set with one SSP Golden Railbird by Kenner.
Colonel Steve Austin, the $6 million man, and the new bionic transport and repair station.
The rocket's crashing! We'll put him in the bionic repair station. We can rebuild him. We'll replace the modules in the bionic arm.
No injury here.
We'll have to check his eye.
Bionic eye, A-OK. $6 million man, ready for action.
New bionic transport and repair station sold separately. The $6 million man, new from Kenner.
What's that, Captain Crunch?
Oh, this? It's my Captain Crunch cereal flag. You see, it says sweet and tasty, a delicious part of a nutritious breakfast. Stays crunchy even in milk. Okay, Sea Dog, run Captain Crunch up the flagpole. Whoop! What the dang flabby? Hey!
Get him down, Sea Dog!
Wait a minute. First, let's see if anybody salutes.
Captain Crunch, from Quaker.
Long may he wave!
Today's star time guest is none other than Steve Exhaustion, better known as the $6.95 man.
What's wrong with Steve, Uncle Croc?
Well, I think he blew a fuse when he blew his nose. Here, Rabbit, here. Here, Steve.
Set this loose, Arum.
I think he slipped his bird. What are we going to do? Maybe his controls need adjusting. Here, let me look.
Watch out for the arrows. Watch out for the low wagons.
You know, I bet this water chewing gum in this bobby pin will fix him up.
Right,
okay. There, that seems to work.
Oh, hi, Uncle Croc.
Hey.
Hi, Mr. Rabbit Ears.
You see, he's as good as new. Well, maybe it was old dumb, Uncle Croc. What? Well, there's another scientific way to fix an old machine. Here, watch.
Croc,
I think he said I can't talk with my foot in my mouth. Well, the same to you, Stevie boy. There he goes, kids. The $6.95 man. Oh. Better make that the 2-bit man.
Every kitty has 9 lives, but 8 of mine went fast. Now there's only 1 life left, and I want to make it last.
Hey, Longtail, come here. You gotta see this. There's that fraidy cat again.
What's he so scared of, fatty catty?
everything. I heard he's even scared of numbers. Yeah, look, he just saw a number on that window.
Look at him run.
Come on, let's have some fun with him.
Good idea, Fatty Catty.
Hey, Fraidy Cat, what you hiding from? A number?
Yeah, the worst number of them all.
It wouldn't be 9, would it?
Yeah, I'm glad you said it.
But nothing happened to me when I said it.
That's because you're on your first life. I'm on number 9. Oops, I said 9. Quick, run.
Run? Not us.
That's right, Fraidy Cat. Run like a chicken.
Cluck, 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 the duck. Oh, not us. He's over there.
Thanks.
I think I'm about to find out how a French fry feels. He's gone, vaporized by his own bolt. Now he's really mad. This kitten is splitting. I lost that cloud. This is one time I got away. Oops, I said one.
Oh, hi, Fraidy. Fraidy? Hey, Ed, have you seen Fraidy?
Where's Fraidy?
I don't know.
Let me see if the coast is clear. Oh, I'm trapped. I gotta get out of here fast. I wonder. When you're desperate, you'll try anything. Don't knock it. I got away, didn't I? He's gone? And he won't be back. Just as long as I don't say that number again. I'll just be extra careful. I'll never even think about it again. Never, 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 never. Every kitty has 9 lives, but 8 of mine went fast. Now there's only 1 life left, and I want to make it last. At last, some peace and quiet. What a windy night. Low bridge. Yeah. And I just had my coat cleaned and pressed. What's with all this sand? Looks like a giant cat box. It's the desert. Oh, I won't last 6 minutes here. Oops!
Make that 6 seconds, Freddy. That is, if I have anything to say about it. Thirsty, eh, Freddy?
What? What?
Boy, it certainly is dry out here. Why, you could wind up as a kitty sandwich. There's my old friend, Ruth Buzzard. Oh, Ruth!
Jasper Catdaver, you old coot! How's business?
Pretty dead, Ruth.
Who's your shaky friend here?
Allow me to introduce my cousin, Freddy Cat.
Ain't hardly nothing to him, is there?
Give him some water, and he might at least do as a snack, hey, Ruthie?
Won't do no harm to try. Follow me!
See, Freddy, you'll be dead. I mean, we'll be there in no time.
There you are, little fella. Drink to your heart's content.
What was that?
Oh, it's that no-good smiley coyote. He's always poaching on my territory.
Ta-ta, Freddy.
Hi there, Smiley Coyote's the name. Desert survival is my game.
You mean you aren't going to eat me?
Well, I considered it, but you don't have enough meat on your bones. I prefer roadrunners. There goes one now. Join me for lunch?
No, thanks.
Suit yourself.
Oh, good grief. I'm soaking with water. This is one time I don't mind being wet. Oops.
Wah, wah.
Oh, Freddy, what are you doing out there in the desert?
Oh, just dying of thirst.
Heck, the old ant can fix some fresh squeezed water. Now go to it, ant.
Oh, boy. Gosh, in the desert, even the water tastes dry.
Tarnation. That's the biggest doggone prairie pooch I ever seen in my life.
Giddy up, Ant. Well, somebody around here sure likes dinosaur steaks.
Where'd he go? I say, where'd he go? My dinner just plumb disappeared.
You eat him? No, sir.
If y'all didn't eat him, maybe I might just as well eat you.
You don't want to eat me. I'm much too skinny. See? Tough. Stringy. Besides, I'm a cat like you.
Another cat? Well, I'll be double dog.
How's about a roar, boy? We cougars always roar. Come on now, boy. Put your back into it.
Me. You.
You sure you're a cougar, boy?
Well, I'm just a young cougar.
Well, then prove it by catching me a tender little prairie dog.
That doesn't look like anybody's home.
Sure, he's in there.
I can't see a thing. He must be 5 feet under.
Whoa! I say whoa! Whoa! Brady, don't tell me. You're a gopher rustler. Is this here ornery critter trying to corral you, little fella?
Oh, Billy, you don't understand.
Stand aside thar, little feller. I'm gonna teach this no-down, no-good hombre a lesson. The code of the West remains untarnished. Yaha! Yaha! Wee wee!
Oh, thank goodness. I've had enough wild animals for a day.
Oh, I say. Looks as though we've gotten something different to eat for a change. A skinny cougar, I believe.
Saturday, come fly with me.
What a jump! Beagle's riding the amazing Sky Cycle. That gyro power sends him over 100 feet at top speed. Loop-de-loop! And he's not through yet! Into the dragster! Evil's super sprint car with built-in drag chute to slow him down! What a hump! And now, the Sky Cycle! That daredevil death-defying supersonic skyplane on wheels. And here he is on the super cool chopper bike! With the power that can really rip! He's sensational! He's Evil Knievel! He's a knockout! He's ideal!
Presenting new Ballerina Barbie. She's beautiful, and you can make her dance like a real ballerina, doing graceful splits, dazzling high kicks, twirling pirouettes, and a perfect arabesque. Ballerina Barbie. She's so beautiful. Ballerina Barbie. She's the doll you make dance. New from Mattel.
Knievel hot seat.
Can't wait to show Bill my Evil Knievel motocross bike.
It's Tank with Evil's initials.
It's Chain Guard with Evil's signature.
It's Bucket Seat.
It's motocross looks, and it's ID plate that says Evil Knievel.
Hey!
The Evil Knievel hot seat and the Evil Knievel motocross bike. Assembly required.
Becomes a series of foul balls. They're really just as opposite as crooked and straight. And no matter where they're going, if there's one that's early, the other one is late. Talk about the oddball couple. They're a couple, that's a couple of oddballs.
is fussy, very proper and clean.
While the other one has got a very special talent for messing up the team.
We're talking about the Oddball Couple. They're a couple that can double as foul balls. Oddballs.
Eight balls.
Sunshine Saturday, come fly with me.
Winnie the Pooh. His name couldn't go on just any kid's clothes. Our new holiday collection had to have Sears exclusive permapressed fabrics for long wear and easy care, with strong seams, color-coordinated good looks, a comfortable just-right fit, and very sensible prices. Pooh-rated quality. For boys and girls sizes 3 to 6X, girls 7 to 14, only in the children's store at Sears.
Fleabag, will you answer the phone? Please!
Reporters and photographers. Today's a day off. Call back Monday. This is the answering service. Bye.
Oh, shucks. Fleabag, this is our day off, but I will not allow you to sleep it away. Just look at you. You are in deplorable condition. I am taking you to the beach for some healthful exercise.
The beach? Exercise? Oh, no. I like me the way I am.
Oh, yes. Exercise will give you pep.
Pep? Pep? I'm too pooped for pep.
We are going to the beach.
No. Negative. Absolutely not. Pretty sandy down here, huh?
First, I shall demonstrate the value of superb condition. Observe how I chin myself. Now, your turn.
Nothing to it. Watch. Oops. You know, that isn't as easy as it looks.
Another test of strength and skill. Observe how my perfectly conditioned body performs with perfect coordination. Now, you, dear friend, let us see what condition you are in.
Oh, this is my cup of tea. I win more Cupid dolls this way. Confounded crackin' brackin' biscuit cutters. I want to go home.
And now, my friend, let's test your physical ability at bowling.
Bowling? Nothing to it. Bowling's right down my alley. You get it? Alley? Bowling?
Save your strength, Fleabag. You'll need it. The bowling alley is a mile down the beach.
A mile? That's inhuman. Let's call a cab, catch a bus, take a train.
The walk will do you good. What happened now, Fleabag?
I tripped on something, Spiffy. It must have been a boulder.
Really, Fleabag? Tripping over an ant? Now, do you admit the value of exercise in building a strong body?
Yeah, I admit. Leave me alone.
No, it's for your own good. Now, watch this. Top that, if you can.
Dang,
well! Oh, poor chap.
I think I must have done something wrong. Boy, I just wish that I could show him that I'm as good as he is.
Aladdin's lamps, get your magic Aladdin's lamps right here. Get them now while they're hot. New.
Hey! Aladdin's lamp! I wonder if there's a genie in one of them. Boy, I could sure use some help right now. I'll take it.
That'll be $2, sir.
But all I got is 50 cents.
I'll take it.
Oh, boy, if there's a genie in here. How do I get the little critter to come out?
Didn't you ever read the story of Aladdin?
Hey, that's right. Now I remember.
Boy, what a sucker.
Oh, hello there. Will you make your wish in a hurry, please, sir? I get so very, very nervous at public appearances. Yes, nervous. Very, very nervous. Oh, gracious me.
Well, crackin', frackin' cracker shells. It is a genie.
Oh, heavens. Please don't stare at me, sir. It makes me blush. Oh, yes, blush. Now I'll write down your wish so I won't forget it. I have to write down everything. I do wish I had a better memory. Now, what was I going to say? Oh, I'm such a forget. Oh, yes, your wish. What is it, please?
Well, what I wish is that I want to be able to beat Spiffy, and then he'll stop nagging me to get exercise.
That's all? Oh, dear, such a simple wish. So very, very simple. I can't do it. No, oh, no, no. Of course I can do it. I keep forgetting I can do anything. I'm a genie. Imagine me a genie. Heavens to Betsy.
Well, when do we start?
You just started. Land sakes, this is such fun.
Hey, where'd you go?
Now, don't worry, I'm here. You don't want your friends to see me, now do you?
Huh? Oh, yeah, yeah, I gotcha.
I'll disappear and appear as you need me.
Oh, oh boy, look out, Spiffy. Here I come.
What do you mean you suddenly feel a new surge of strength? You still look out of shape to me.
Oh, yeah? Well, just try me, buddy. I'll show you that I'm in shape.
All right, Fleabag. I shall not hesitate to humiliate you once again. After you, my dear Fleabag.
We'll show 'em, Genie, huh? Observe. With my pinky only. Now you, my dear Spiffy.
I can't get off the ground. I don't understand it. I was in condition a few hours ago. I don't know what happened before, Fleabag, but this time I'll show you.
Sure you will, pal. Sure you will. Having a bit of trouble throwing your weight around, buddy? I'll show you who's in shape. Ready to jog, old boy?
Jog? Where? Oh, yes! And now I'll show you. On your mark, get set, go! This time I'll show him. Sure pays to stay in shape. This time I've got him. At last, finish line. Oh, I've shown him. Whew. Now maybe he'll believe me.
What kept you, Spiffy, old buddy?
I give up, Fleabag. I don't know how you do it, but you do it. I'm pooped.
Naturally. And to show you what good shape I'm in, I'm going to perform the most sensational stunt since the invention of bubble gum. I am going to dive into that little pool at the bottom
of that 200-foot platform.
No, Fleabag, it's impossible. Besides, you're not that good at swimming.
Ah, that's what you'd think. Oh, boy, oh, boy. That genie and I are really showing Spiffy a thing or three.
I can't understand it. I just can't understand it. I'm seeing it, but not believing it.
Feast your eyeballs on this. Gee, boy, I'm sure glad you're up here with me, genie.
Oh, you. I bet you say that to all the genies. Don't worry, I'm right behind you.
Okay, here we go! Hey, what's that?
Oh, that! That's my wristwatch. My wife hates it when I'm late for supper. So long, bye!
Hey, Genie, wait! I'm not down yet! Hey, don't leave me! Ever get the feeling you're about to get into something over your head? I gotta start exercising and get back into shape.
Fleabag, you've been sweeping and mopping in there for over an hour. How are you doing?
Great! The room's almost finished.
Fine! I'm proud of the effort you're making. Well, you can't win them all.
Hello, Fleabag and Spiffy, ace reporters. We got a news for news. News for news. No job will unnerve us. We're at your service.
Fleabag, that is your shoe.
Huh? Oh. Hello? Hello? No, it doesn't matter. They hung up anyway.
Honestly, Fleabag, I hope you'll accept this remark without offense, but you are about the most unkempt, uncouth, disorganized reporter I have ever met.
Okay. What are you buttering me up for? If you want a favor, just come out and ask for it.
Oh, what's the use? Oh, Miss Goldie Howe, would you come in here, please?
Yoo-hoo, anybody home?
No, nobody here. We're all out to lunch.
Goodness, my watch must be slow. Is it lunchtime already?
No, it is not, Miss Howe. Has the mail arrived yet?
No mail, just this travel magazine.
Well, thank goodness, no bills.
Travel magazine? Is that the one with the story about the guy crossing the ocean on a raft?
Ooh, how stupid. With all the modern modes of travel today, the man must be out of his head.
Out of his head? That guy sold his story for 100,000 clams.
100,000 clams? Dollars? You don't say.
Check with all the used boat lots, Miss Hound. We gotta get our hands on a canoe.
Yes, sir. Right away. A used canoe?
Right. I could just see it now. How we crossed the ocean in a canoe. What a story. I'll make a mint.
Just a minute, Fleabag. Nothing personal. But that is the most utterly ridiculous idea you have come up with yet. It can't be done.
Okay. So now we know it can't be done.
That does it, Fleabag. Shipwreck. And we don't even know where we are. Oh, how could you do this to me?
Now, wait a minute. Don't get on your high horse. It wasn't my fault that the canoe tipped over.
No, it wasn't.
No, and it wasn't my idea that I should wash my socks.
You could have taken them off to wash them instead of hanging your feet over the side. If for the preservation of our friendship, Fleabag, I suggest that from here on out, it's every man for himself. If you can manage without me.
Oh, a trial split up, huh? Well, that's okay with me. I'll manage. I'm tired of having to be so neat anyway.
This is the life. Being shipwrecked isn't so bad after all. I hope Fleabag is making out as well as I am.
Lunchtime. But where's the lunch?
Lunch on Saturday. Come fly with me.
My tummy wants something yummy. Super Sugar Crisp. It's coated with golden sugar.
Golden sugar?
Yep. Makes it yummy for your tummy.
Well, I got it.
Me too. Super Sugar Crisp. It's part of a balanced breakfast.
A glow monster inside.
Put it together.
Hold them under the light.
Turn off the light.
Filmed in black light.
Frankenstein.
The Wolfman.
The Mummy.
Phantom of the Opera.
One in each specially marked box of post-Super Sugar Crisp cereal.
What's part pinball, part target game, and has a lot of junk? The Junkyard Game. The object is to knock off as much junk and score as many points as you can. But don't hit the broken window. Herbie needs a shoe, an old tire, and a rusty can. There's the can. And there's the tire. All he needs is... Oh, no! He hit the broken window. Junkyard. A game any number can play. From Ideal.
Breathe in chocolate.
Breathe out mint.
That's Tootsie Roll Minties.
Koopa, Ollie, what's going on?
We're enjoying Tootsie Roll Minties, friend. Oh?
Minties are chewy, chocolatey Tootsie Roll and refreshing mint.
Now breathe in and out.
Chocolate. Mint.
Breathe in chocolate.
Breathe out mint.
That's Tootsie Roll Minties.
On the phone.
Oh, shipwrecked on a deserted island. I should have packed a peanut butter and tuna sandwich just in case.
Hey, look at here. Just what the chef ordered. Crab Louie.
Okay, Louie, it's between you and me. It's a case of survival. My survival. Hey, is this any way to treat a lunch guest? Okay, wise guy, best two out of three. No tricks now. Okay, how about three out of four? I'll teach you to sneak away, you crabby crab. Nice octopussy. Funny, I've suddenly lost my craving for seafood. What a crummy place to put coconuts. Just out of a guy's reach. Ooh, the confounded cuckamimi coconuts. I'll show you. I'll use my head. That's what I'll do. Oh! Ooh, that hurt. Hey, get your banana picking hands off of my coconuts. They're mine. Stop, thief! Come back here! Bastard biscuit cutter. Now where did he go? Aha! Bananas! Food! Beautiful gold food. Spiffy's not the only guy that's going to live it up. I'll have banana splits, banana bread, banana croquettes, banana soup. Sure doesn't taste like banana. Doesn't even feel like bananas. You confounded flutter wrap cockamamie cracker flaps! Wait till I get my hands on that fugitive from another planet! Well, I'll be doggone!
Here you are, my good man! One for you, and 49 for me! 50-50!
50-50, huh? Sounds reasonable to me. Wait a minute. Those are my bananas. So that's it. My ex-buddy's got that food-hogging ape on his side, eh? Well, we'll see about that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Mama Doo, is my morning shower ready yet? One for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, and let her go. Oh, you are such an improvement over Fleabag, Mama Doo. You're so neat. You make an ideal mirror. You may prepare breakfast now, if you please. What is it? What's the matter? Oh, so that's it. Someone has stolen all my coconuts, eh? Well, and what have we here?
Oh, hi, Spiffy. Say, do you have a can opener on you? You'd think that they'd have a pull tab on these things. A guy could starve to death while trying to open them.
I'd say we caught the thief with the goods, wouldn't you?
I'm sorry, buddy. I had to do it. You got all the food on the island. Look, I'll make it up to you, buddy. Just give me a bowl of crumbs. I'll do anything. You name it, anything.
Come to think of it, Marmaduke, you do need a rest.
Be your man Friday? Mop the floors? Wash the dishes? Well, you tricked me, confounded clever buttermilk.
Now, my friend. Temper, temper. A deal is a deal.
Fries, crinkled lettuce leaves, sour biscuit batter. With friends like him, who needs enemies? Ironing shirts. It's a waste of time. Who's gonna see you on a deserted island?
You never know. A steamer could rescue us any day now. The sooner, the better.
Oh, yeah. Suppose it's a tramp steamer. What tramp wears pressed shirts? Wanna give him an inferiority complex?
Never mind. Just iron, and don't forget the cuffs.
You cuffs. Bless buttonholes, crummy collars.
When you finish those dishes, wash and iron that pile of clothes over there.
What do you mean? I just did.
Oh, never mind. Just finish the dishes. It's almost time for tea. I'm having a guest.
Tea? Oh, boy, tea. Tea and crumpets. That's as good as food. Oh, I'm going to be a guest. Oh, Spiffy's not such a bad ex-friend after all. Spiffy, old buddy, old pal, I finished the dishes, and I even mopped out your shower again to boot.
Very good, Fleabag. My guest should be arriving shortly.
I got news for you, pal. He just arrived.
I've got news for you. You're not my guest.
I'm not?
Come in, Marmaduke. Fleabag, my man Friday is about to serve.
Me serve crumpets to an ape?
Why not? At least he wiped his feet before coming into my parlor. Cheers, Marmaduke. Here's to an early rescue.
That does it. This island isn't big enough for the three of us.
Fleabag, wait! Don't leave me!
Washing, ironing, mopping, and who needs it? I'll find my own island. That's what I'll do. I'll find my own.
Wait! Come back! I was only kidding. Really, old buddy? What's so funny, Marmaduke? Where are we going? Not so fast! City Zoo! Fleabag! Wait! Come back, old buddy! I've got something important to tell you!
You blasted French fries, crinkled lettuce leaves, sour biscuit batter with friendly crying.
We never left home! Wait a minute! What am I doing? He'll be back when he gets hungry enough.
Lunch on Saturday, come fly with me!
These people have just chosen the taste of Golden Griddle over pure maple syrup when they didn't know which was which. Now let's ask them about the bottle.
Oh, this is it. Very attractive bottle.
This top is neat. Really neat. You know, it doesn't get all sticky and messy.
My kids make puddles of syrup. Squeezing it on, we probably won't waste as much.
My little sister will love this bottle. She's always knocking things down.
Golden Griddle, the taste that beat pure maple in a very exciting bottle.
I'm thirsty riding a skateboard.
Me too. This is a job for Kool-Aid. Hey, Kool-Aid!
Oh yeah, Kool-Aid's here, bringing you fun. Kool-Aid's got the
first on the run, get a big, wide, happy ear to hear
Kool-Aid smile.
Mmm, tastes great. Our friend's cool.
Our friend's Kool-Aid.
Kool-Aid brown soft drink mix.
Oh, yeah.
Tobruk, Tripoli, El Alamein, the desert battlefields of World War II. MB presents Tank Battle, a military strategy game of six tanks against six. Set up mines and keep them secret. Cut off fuel supplies and slow down the enemy. Fire shots where you predict enemy tanks will go. Confront an enemy tank and destroy it with a higher number. Destroy all six and you've won the battle. Tank Battle, a game of military strategy from MB Games.
Wrench!
Wrench!
Socket!
Socket!
Lugs!
Motor!
Tires!
Chassis! Speed buggy!
That's me! They raced today.
Antifreeze in my carburetor. Yuck.
Time for timer.
What?
No time for breakfast. Now look, since 6 o'clock last night, you haven't eaten a bite. Come on, I'll show you why that's really not the way for a growing kid to start a busy day. Here we are inside your body, and this noisy, empty space is your stomach getting angry because there's no food in the place. Uh-oh, let's find some food fast. Now listen. I don't want you to think this is the best way to eat breakfast, but in case you can't cook, and if you haven't time for a good cereal in a well-balanced meal, then this quickie breakfast is better than nothing at all, okay? Hey, here's orange juice and milk and fruit juice waiting to be taken. And bless my soul, right here's a bowl with one cold piece of steak in, a hard-boiled egg or chicken leg or cheese or luncheon meat, or a peanut butter sandwich. Any time of day's a treat. So to keep your mom from grumbling and stop that stomach rumbling and keep your legs from stumbling when you play, you gotta eat some kind of breakfast every day.
Lunch on Saturday, come fly with me.
It comes with two teams of little figures. You can make them shoot the balls and do all sorts of other things, like work the automatic pin setter and the automatic ball return. You can choose up sides and, with luck, make a strike for your team. The Brunswick Bowling Center, from Child Guidance.
If anyone can give a kid a dish that's a treat, 'cause it's fun to eat, Franco American.
It's scared of a meatball. It's very good and very, very slippery.
I like to hide the meatballs and save them for later.
If anyone can make spaghetti that's long on fun, to the last one, Franco American.
Planet of the Apes.
A funny crocodile, a hobby horse, a yellow frog, a monkey with a smile, a cuckoo bird, an apple tree, a willy walrus, a moo moo cow, a bumblebee, a platypus, an elephant, a ball, a house, a polka dot giraffe, an aeroplane, a ship, a mouse, a face to make you laugh. Play-Doh, Play-Doh, you can make it with Play-Doh.
Every Play-Doh 4-pack has four blendable colors. Play-Doh, from the Play-Doh people.
Middleman, two kids eating the middles out of their Oreo cookies, corner 4th and Elm.
Oh!
Please don't fiddle with the Oreo middle. Don't tear them apart, have a heart.
But Middleman, you gotta eat the Frosty Cream middles first. Then you get two crunchy chocolate outside to eat less.
Oh! Then go ahead and fiddle with the Oreo middle.
'Cause there's not a better middle you can fiddle with.
Oh, I like it.
Good work.
We can only take along what we absolutely need, Nova. Anything extra can slow us down.
How much longer before the rafts will be finished?
A couple of days at the most.
We have to hurry. Urko's attack may come at any time.
I know.
Dr. Zeus, what a pleasant surprise. To what do we owe the pleasure of your visit?
I believe, my children, that without knowing it, I am greatly in your debt.
What do you mean, sir?
Whoever stole the aircraft from Urko has saved apekind from being taken over by his military dictatorship. Only a citizen of great loyalty would have risked so much to capture that plane and save our society. And I have come here to express my gratitude for your heroism.
Dr. Zeus, truly you don't think we stole Urko's plane?
I know your quiet modesty and the danger you would be in if Urko found out, but your secret is safe with me, and I will never forget your loyalty.
But, Dr. Zeus, we had nothing to do with it. We were...
My child, you have nothing to fear. Urko has no idea who stole the plane. Besides, he has asked to mount a reconnaissance force against the caves of the humanoids. I have reluctantly given him my permission. He claims he will find your blue eyes there. It will keep him occupied, and you two will be safe from suspicion.
We're ready to shove off, Bill.
Good. We can cover a lot of distance before nightfall.
I wonder what New Valley will be like. Whether it will offer the kind of protection the humanoids need.
Cornelius thought it would. And according to the map he gave us, New Valley is sure remote.
Any place has to be safer than these caves.
Okay, let's move out.
Nova tells me some of the humanoids have become ill. They want to turn back.
There's no turning back, Judy. We have to go on. It's our only hope.
I wonder if there was an easier way to reach New Valley.
I trust Cornelius. If there was, he would have told us.
Just a little more and we'll be through the worst of it.
What's that noise?
I don't know. Bill, watch out!
In the air like this. The movement might scare them away. Nova, like this. Wave your arms like this.
That's it, Nova. That's it.
We did it. They're gone.
Let's get going.
I wonder what's beyond that turn.
It's incredible. One moment we're in a jungle thicker than I thought could have existed. And the next, we're in an area where there's not a solitary sign of life.
According to the map, we should be coming to the place where we leave the river and continue the journey overland.
How will we ever get all the way up there?
Scoundrels, thieves, traitors. That's who it was. Traitors to apekind who stole my aircraft. Never have I been so humiliated. And to think, there I was on the brink of total power. I want the aircraft returned, do you understand? I demand it be recaptured at once.
We're doing our best, sir.
Your best isn't good enough. Or else, how do you explain allowing the plane to be stolen from under your noses in the first place?
We're narrowing down our list of suspects, General Urko.
To me, you're all suspects. How do I know it wasn't one of you who betrayed me? This entire mess smacks of an inside job. After all, the existence of the airplane was a closely guarded military secret, unknown to anyone on the outside.
Well, someone on the outside must have known about it, sir.
I want an immediate review of all security procedures. I will give a reward of 1,000 pieces of simian silver to the patriotic ape who exposes the guilty party. Now, what about our plan of attack on the humanoids?
The army's ready, sir. All units have been alerted and are prepared to march.
Good. What we need now is a smashing victory to restore confidence in the military.
Yes, sir.
We move out at dawn!
I'm so worried, Cornelius. Urko's attack on the humanoid's cave is imminent. It will be a catastrophe if his army finds Bill, Jeff, and Judy there.
I know, Zira, I know.
Isn't there anything we can do to help them?
You and I have done more for the humanoids than any apes have ever done. No, Zira, there's nothing more we can do except maybe hope that Jeff and Judy and Bill can return the humanoids to New Valley before Urko and his army catches up with them.
The heat. It's like a furnace.
But we've got to go on.
Have some water.
There seems to have been quite a bit of activity at the riverbank, General.
What would the humanoids be doing at the river? They're too stupid to swim! Wait a minute. Rafts! The humanoids must have somehow understood to chop down those trees to build rafts! They're trying to escape via the river. After them! After them!
But, General, we're not prepared for river travel.
Why not?
We didn't bring any amphibious craft with us.
Fool! Call headquarters and have riverboats brought up!
Sir, I believe we must first secure permission from the Council of Elders for this type of operation.
Run on the Council of Elders! They're nothing but a bunch of old freaking apes!
If it wasn't for them, I would have rid us of the humanoid problem years ago.
But, General, the laws are very strict.
I know. I know. Call for the river craft and keep the army in full readiness. I'll push this thing through the council, no matter what kind of threats I have to make.
To find shelter. And quick.
Wait a minute. What's that?
It's a mesa of some sort. It'll help protect us. How long do you figure the storm will last?
I don't know. It doesn't seem to be getting any better.
We better count on spending the night here.
I can't believe it. Bill, it's a spaceship. An American spaceship.
Incredible. Another astronaut has crash-landed on this planet.
This ship could have gone through the same time warp we did.
But whose craft is it? And how long has it been here?
The dog tag Nova's wearing. Brent,
This must be Colonel Brent's rocket ship.
Brent? But where is he?
You mean he is still alive?
But... Brent... 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 Brent...
When the game's called off and you're feeling sad, the Snoopy drive-in movie can make you feel glad.
Three D-type batteries not included.
Look out, Snoopy! I can even make it go backwards!
Watching Snoopy's fun to do. You can get a groovy Snoopy movie viewer, too.
Kenner's new Snoopy drive-in movie and movie viewer sold separately, each with one cassette.
Hi, gang. Big Fig here with that great new dance, the Newton. Hit it, Hal.
Gooey, gooey, rich and chewy inside. Golden, flaky, tender, cakey outside. Wrap the inside in the outside. Is it good? Darn tootin', doing the big, big Newton. Here's the tricky part. The big, big Newton. One more time. The big, big Newton.
I do everything fast.
Marathon John?
You can't eat a marathon candy bar fast, Quick Claude. It lasts a good long time.
I show you. Milk chocolate, delicious caramel, and chewy.
Told you. Nobody eats a marathon bar quick, Claude.
Marathon lasts a good long time.
Lunch on Saturday, come fly with me.
Nova, Nova, you were just a little girl when I saw you last. How you've grown and how pretty you are.
When exactly was your flight launched, Colonel Brent?
Ron, call me Ron. I was launched August 6th, 2109, from a site in the Mojave Desert.
Mojave Desert? What happened to Cape Kennedy?
Cape Kennedy was turned into a space museum at least 60 years before I was born.
But if you were launched more than 150 years after us, how did you get here before we did?
I guess we made quite a bit of progress in rocket fuels and capsule design in those 150 years.
Yes, I guess so.
As best I can calculate, I crash-landed here some 15 to 20 years ago. I can't tell exactly, because it's pretty difficult to keep track of time in the desert. After the crash landing, when I came to, I discovered my leg was broken. I was alone and unable to take care of myself. Things got pretty hairy for a while. Then, quite by chance, I was found by a tribe of wanderers who seemed to be straight out of prehistoric times. Well, they were friendly enough and remained with me while I convalesced. That's when I met Nova. She was one of the tribe's children. I taught her to say my name and she adopted me. After I was well enough to walk, I decided to accompany the tribe to wherever it was they were going. However, during a sandstorm, I became separated from the group and was never able to find them again. So I returned to my ship and made it my headquarters. I've been living alone in the desert ever since. Over the years, I've made many forays into the wilderness, hoping to find the tribe. I had all but given up hope.
Well, Ron, on behalf of all of us, welcome back to the human race.
Thank you. Thank you all.
We'd better be on our way.
I still don't know what brought you this way. Where are you leading the tribe?
To a place called New Valley.
According to this map, it lies about 25 miles south of here.
I know the valley. I used to go there to fish. I can lead you there.
That's great. Let's get started.
Ron, is there anything in the spacecraft you want to take along?
Nothing much survived, except me, the spaceship, and its self-destruct mechanism.
Self-destruct mechanism, huh? Let's take it along. It just might come in handy someday.
Sure thing. It won't take but a few minutes to disengage.
Good. That'll give me a chance to fill you in on the one rather unusual aspect of this planet.
General Urko, it is the opinion of this council that your military leadership leaves a great deal to be desired.
How dare you question my ability?
It comes into serious question, General Urko, when you spend a great deal of time publicly preparing to do battle with an enemy you can't even locate.
Let the Council grant me permission to pursue the humanoid beasts. I give you my oath. I will take proper care of them.
Frankly, we have absolutely no reason to place any confidence in your promises.
Let me give them chase! I shall hunt down the humanoids and make you eat your words.
If your recent performance is any indication, I rather doubt that, General.
The blue-eyed beast is leading them away. Who knows when they may return in numbers, armed, crazed, to infest our cities, threaten our children.
You may launch a mission to find out where they have gone, but you will require a mandate from the Council of Elders before you may attack.
Beautiful.
This place is everything you had hoped it would be?
Now, if we can construct the proper defenses, perhaps the humanoids can finally find some peace and tranquility.
Look at those boulders. The laser drill should be able to cut through them to make building blocks.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's get started.
Sniveling Dr. Zaius a thing or two. Imagine him doubting my ability. What insolence.
The motorized units are ready to move out, sir.
Well, why have we delayed? Let's go, on the double.
How's it going?
Fine. The humanoids are quick to learn.
There's still a lot left to be done.
Advanced scouts have picked up the humanoids' trail, sir.
Good. Where are they?
They seem to be moving through the southern desert.
The southern desert? That region hasn't even been explored yet. I wonder where they are headed.
We don't know, sir.
Why not? Why can't I get a straight answer from anybody? Is there a conspiracy against me?
No, sir.
When we locate the humanoid beasts, we may have to attack in self-defense. Speed up the convoy!
The pueblos are almost complete. All that remains are a few finishing touches.
They seem solid enough.
Just like the Indians in Arizona and New Mexico once had.
Their pueblos lasted for hundreds of years. I wonder if these will be granted as much time.
Only the centuries will tell.
Faster! Move them faster! Charge!
Urko has followed us here. Quick, get everyone inside the pueblos.
Now we have to hope our strategy works.
Let's all keep our fingers crossed.
Retreat! Retreat!
Impossible! The humanoid beasts are too stupid to know how to defend themselves.
Our grenades just couldn't penetrate the shutters, General.
And our ladders aren't long enough to reach the doors of the buildings.
Then order the artillery to be brought up.
Sir, we didn't bring the howitzers with us.
What? You mean we came all this way without the proper weapons? Idiots! You're all idiots! I can't rely on any of you for anything. Here we have the entire tribe of humanoid beasts trapped, and we can't finish them off. You'll all pay dearly for this.
What should we do, General?
You'll do nothing. From now on, I will do. The army is to return to Ape City. It will be resupplied with every piece of military equipment known to ape kind. I'll rid this planet of the humanoid plague yet.
Our worries aren't over yet. The gorillas are sure to attack again. And this time, they're bound to employ all of their firepower.
What can we do? These pueblos will never withstand an artillery barrage.
Our only chance is to stop the guerrilla army from entering New Valley.
But with artillery firepower behind them, it'll be impossible.
Not if we destroy the land bridge.
Destroy the land bridge? How?
With Ron's spacecraft self-destruct mechanism. We'll use it to blow up the land bridge.
Sure. That way, Urko will never be able to roll his heavy guns into the valley.
Great idea. Well, what are we waiting for?
Did you set the charge, Jeff?
It's all set. How about yours?
Roger. Let's go.
Okay. Nova, you may have the honor of pressing the igniter button. We sure have. They'll never be able to get us now.
We still have to get the airplane.
There are guerrilla soldiers everywhere out there.
I know, but it has to be done. The apes are bound to attack again, and soon.
Hey, kid, have a carrot.
A carrot?
Carrot sticks are, yes, indeed. They are delicious. If you must eat in between meals, why not eat nutritious dishes? Like fill a bowl with ice cubes, then add raw cauliflower. Stuff celery with cheese and let it chill for half an hour. Add carrot sticks and olives and any other knickknacks. Then keep this by the TV set for when you want those quick snacks. Well?
Well, but while I'm waiting, could you make me a banana?
Okay, you're a banana.
It's a beautiful day for this trap tennis match. In the center for 2 points. The object of trap tennis is to hit the ball and try to trap it for either 1 or 2 points. There's a one-pointer. The first player to score 10 points wins. First match point. Johnson serving. It's a smash. No, it's a backhand fake. Trap tennis, a smashing game. From Ideal.
What's that, Captain Crunch?
Oh, this? It's my Captain Crunch cereal flag. You see, it says sweet and tasty, a delicious part of a nutritious breakfast. Stays crunchy even in milk. Okay, Sea Dog, run Captain Crunch up the flagpole. Whoop! What the dang flabby? Hey!
Get him down, Sea Dog!
Wait a minute. First, let's see if anybody salutes.
Captain Crunch, from Quaker.
Long may he wave!
Thank you.
bizarre. His wolf suit and made mischief of one kind and another. His mother called him Wild Thing, and Max said, I'll eat you up. So he was sent to bed without eating anything. That very night, in Max's room, a forest grew. And grew. And grew. Until his ceiling hung with vines. And the walls became the world all around. And an ocean tumbled by with a private boat for Max. And he sailed off through night and day. And in and out of weeks. And almost over a year. To where the wild things are. And when he came to the place where the wild things are, they roared their terrible roars and gnashed their terrible teeth and rolled their terrible eyes and showed their terrible claws till Max said, be still. Tamed them with the magic trick of staring into all their yellow eyes without blinking once. And they were frightened and called him the most wild thing of all and made him king of all wild things. And now, cried Max, let the wild rumpus start! And sent the wild things off to bed without their supper. And Max, the king of all wild things, was lonely and wanted to be where someone loved him best of all. Then all around, from far away across the world, he smelled good things to eat. So he gave up being king of where the wild things are. But the wild things cried, oh, please don't go. We'll eat you up. We love you so. And Max said, no. The wild things roared their terrible roars and gnashed their terrible teeth and rolled their terrible eyes and showed their terrible claws. But Max stepped into his private boat and waved goodbye. and sailed back over a year. And in and out of weeks, and through a day, and into the night of his very own room, where he found his supper waiting for him. And it was still hot.
What you see on ABC Saturday mornings, you'll be talking about all weekend. You'll be talking about Hong Kong Fooey, a canine crusader who changes from janitor to crime fighter at the close of a drawer. About the new adventures of Gilligan and his shipwrecked friends. About Devlin, three kids out on their own together as a motorcycle stunt team. About Korg, 70,000 BC, a family struggling to survive in prehistoric times. And These Are the Days, about a turn-of-the-century family in rural America. Five bright new shows, part of Funshine Saturday, each week. Also this season, 14 after-school specials, continuing in the tradition of the Emmy-winning Rookie of the Year. And there's plenty of special early evening entertainment for the whole family to enjoy together, including a special showing of David Hartman's Birth and Babies, ABC programs for children. We take our kids seriously.